Fine. It's the Poker Party coming to you from Santa Monica, and we don't usually run old film clips, but we found these old sepia tone things of the old Big Sandy band, so we'll run a couple of them before we start the show. Let's take a look at another one of those clips. Run it, fellas.
Well, when I left the house, told to see where you are. I'm gonna buy you a brand new car, buy you pretty clothes and a heavy thing. I might even buy you a diamond ring. I heard as I walked away, I knew that he's gonna fall someday. I never could quite figure it out. I just didn't know what he was talking about. Dadgummit, how come it, dadgummit, woo, how come it, you done it, how come it, dadgummit, how come it, girl, you're leaving me alone like this, yeah. Any man, up stepped the woman, trotting up to my side. She said, come on, Sandy, let's take a ride. I tried to kiss her by the railroad tracks. She made me walk every step the way back. Dadgummit, how come it, dadgummit, woo, how come it, dadgummit, honey, baby, you done it. How come it, dadgummit, girl, you're leaving me alone like this.
You know, where was that stuff from? Was that the Cliffy Stone Barn Dance?
I mean,
we were lucky it's in such good shape, that film.
Yeah, I know, man. It was just amazing. Just turn the channel, and voila, there it was.
Yeah, it was pretty good. So we got that on some old kinescopes the archives back at one of the little L.A. stations. And if we ever hear from that band again, we'll have them on the show. I understand they're here in town still.
Well,
the Big Sandy Band.
Yeah, that's what I hear.
Well, we'll try and get them around here later. Let's start the show. This is Art Fine's Poker Party with some a couple regular guests and a special guy. A special guy is the first time in, Lindsay Hutton. Lindsay?
Hi.
Lindsay's a Scottish lad who puts out the magazine Next Big Thing out of, is that out of Edinburgh?
It's out of Grangemouth, which is halfway between Glasgow and Edinburgh.
All right, well, let me introduce the other guys and ask you a few more questions after that. Next to him, I got Dave Alvin. Dave.
Hello, Art.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Dave, your latest project wasn't you. It was Sonny Burgess, right?
Yes, sir.
Sonny Burgess, the famous Sun Records guy.
Famous to some people.
Famous to those in the know.
Yeah.
We Want a Boogie and numerous other great records.
Redheaded Woman, yeah.
And you just produced a record for him on Rounder?
On Hightone.
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 Okay.
My label, Hightone.
The label you're on.
Label I own.
Okay. Well, we look at, what's the name of that Sonny Burgess album?
It's called Tennessee Border, and It's possibly the greatest record ever made.
Is that right?
Yeah,
well, I'll be looking in my record stores. Are there any more record stores anymore? What are they? They have to be record stores.
Well, they still call them record stores.
Yeah, so I'll be looking in my record stores for it. And
well,
I'll
looking CD. In CD stores, yeah. There's not a record of it. It's just a CD.
All right. Next to him, another man that's occasionally on vinyl, but not very often. Or on
vinyl?
Well, you were on vinyl, weren't you?
Oh, that's true. Yeah, a couple of times.
With the band? What was the band?
Oh, well, with my band, The Cheeks of Shake, that was a long time ago. But
that's why you were on vinyl.
Yeah, but I'm also with the poetry stuff.
Oh, so Paul Bode,
every year, you're a poet.
There's a couple of poets here.
Yeah,
actually.
Yeah.
So your poet stuff, what's that?
Golly, I did a thing about Elvis called Pink and Black years and years and years ago.
Where did that appear?
Harvey Kubernick.
It was on Harvey's thing, and then
what
I did
Harvey's thing. What? Do I go to the store and ask for Harvey's thing? What is it?
I forget the name of that.
Okay. I think Harvey Kubernick's poetry records are harder to find than the little big Sandy Cat scopes.
Anyhow, so you appeared on an early poetry comedy.
Oh, I'm on all of them. I'm on.
And
you're
coming up to another one.
Yeah, I'm on all of them.
What's the new one?
I'm on one about sports. Then I'm going to have one
sport.
Myself.
You're going to have your own record?
Yeah, well, my own CD.
Really?
Yeah.
Who's doing that, Harvey?
Yeah.
Well, Harvey, come on.
Yeah.
What's the name of the one?
It's called Love is Like Rasputin.
And it's, okay.
Yeah. But it's my own thing, and it's on New Alliance, and it's together, man. Uh-huh. It's all about chasing girls in 1965. You know what that was like.
Yeah.
It was fun.
What was it like?
It was fun.
I wasn't catching any then, though.
No, it was fun. Well, you know, nobody.
Why don't you write about 75? Yeah. You're probably catching them in 75.
Yeah, but who wants to write about 75, man? It was better than 65.
All right,
speaking of girls.
Oh, there she is. There's the sweetest girl in the world right there.
We're going to get a shot of
Jessie.
Uh-oh, she's going to stay. We got my daughter, little Jessie, here. And she's here to entertain us also.
Yeah.
All right, so Lindsay, we got a standard question, which is, what's the first record you ever bought?
Well, Fireball by Don Spencer, which was the theme song for Fireball XL5, a Gerry Anderson puppet show.
Puppet show. How about the first rock and roll record you bought?
It was probably T-Rex, Ride the White Swan.
Yeah? Cool. And what about over there in Bonnie, Scotland? What was the first rock and roll show you saw?
The first rock and roll show I saw was Free.
Yeah?
Yeah, but I like to think it was Alice Cooper. That was actually the second one I was taking along to Free.
Oh, you don't like Free?
Nah, you know.
They're kind of good.
Nah. I just messed up by a couple of years. Cooper was the thing.
They had a messed up name because that band, whenever they paid to play, it was always said, tonight, Alice Cooper so-and-so, Free, and then people would think they didn't have to pay to get in.
Well, that's right. And they had a lot of people. For every time somebody filled them.
Let me switch over to Dave Alvin for a minute. You mentioned the movie Weekend in Vegas. Are you in it?
Honeymoon in Vegas.
Yeah. Is it just open?
Yeah, I went and saw it Saturday night. And I worked for, I did a week of doing, got hired to do like Elvis in Las Vegas music.
Uh-huh.
Like Teddy Bear and...
I said you were doing Elvis, I mean...
I produce and arrange this stuff.
You were singing it?
No. They had various Elvis imitators singing it.
I mean,
we did the
you're a great singer, but I don't think you're the first person I'd call to do Elvis imitations.
What I was doing, Art, was I got hired to do like a certain amount of music so they could film a scene of Elvis imitators in Las Vegas, and then for the movie, like guys that can't sing but are serious Elvis imitators.
Uh-huh.
So they wanted it to be real Vegas-y, so we had horns, background singers, modulations, every cornball thing you could think of, you know, big drum. Then we filmed it in Vegas for 3 days, all expenses paid. And it's a funny movie, but I took this woman with me, and I'm like, yeah, I'm in the movie. It's coming up soon. I'm in the movie.
Yeah.
Like that. Yeah. I mean, you see my face, like, just kind of go.
Well, I thought you said, like that, I could get a woman to go with me if I was going to be in a movie.
No, I mean, I was in the movie like that, so I had to do some big explaining.
Speaking of you and movies, somebody else told me they saw some kind of movie or video featuring Nick Cave, and if you go to his apartment, and he has a gigantic Dave Alvin poster on the wall for the first album. How about that, huh?
I go to Nick Cave's house?
No, you, the viewer. I mean, in the movie, whatever the video is, it's in Nick Cave's apartment. I think it's a movie. I'm not sure what it is. And they said they saw a gigantic...
Is it Johnny Sway?
Johnny Sway. I saw it.
I can't remember that. I saw Johnny Sway.
I would certainly have
seen it. Maybe it was a video.
Maybe it was something else.
It was
probably
a video.
But that's good, huh? Something else here, too. Oh, and so you said, by the way, you're Sonny Burgess, back to you.
Yeah.
The Sonny Burgess CD has been reviewed in such an August publication, or maybe it was a July issue, of Now Dig This,
which
is a British rockabilly specialty magazine.
Yeah.
And they went completely ape over it.
Yeah, it's kind of nice because the English rockabilly people actually never liked the Blasters.
Uh-huh.
I always thought we were a heavy metal band.
Well, wait a second. Now, you would have been a heavy metal band,
sort of.
Compared
to them, yeah.
No. But you would have been if you had your way towards the beginning right now.
Me?
Wait, yeah, you. Because
I like playing loud.
What?
I don't like heavy metal, but I like playing loud.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Loud,
I'm saying that I've got a 1980 tape of the Blasters, the Whiskey, and you guys. And what's really great is your guitar mic is turned off on the board tape because you're going to play so loud, but it leaks in through Phil's mic so monstrously that I thought you were on the verge of something really great, of some kind of loud, metallic, screaming rockabilly. But then luckily...
No, then we kind of wimped out this weekend.
Then you kind of wimped out and brought that Joe Turner cassette to the recording studio to make sure everything sounded like 1956.
I didn't do that.
Oh, no, it was the other guy, yeah.
The other guy.
But I know, the good thing, the drum sound on Shake, Rattle, and Roll, the snare drum sound on Shake, Rattle, and Roll by Joe Turner is incredible.
Yeah, it is. Yeah,
and you could do it now with the technology they have now, you could maybe get that drum sound, you know. But
and that's what you're going for.
I think what the band was going for was, I don't know, was, you know.
No.
I mean, we changed. I mean, because we were, you know, in those days we were playing with the Cramps and Black Flag and people like that. So it was, the guitars had to be loud.
But wasn't
then
that a direction?
It changed where when we brought in the keyboards and the horns, they made me turn down.
Oh, they made you turn down. So let's think about that for a second. Let's say you didn't bring in the keyboard and the horns. The Blasters might have gone another direction if you had your way.
Well,
I'm not trying to make trouble.
Know.
I'm just trying to say that it was good.
Know.
It was really good when you had that.
One time, no, it, just, it made sense at one time to, when we were a four-piece band to be, you know, loud. And then it made sense later on not to be loud.
Hmm. Okay. Well, what? What, they're here? The Big Sandy Band.
No.
They saw themselves on TV and they came running down here. Holy smoke.
Oh, my God.
That's
my heroes.
That's unbelievable. Well, okay, now they got little Jesse on the floor, but I got to talk to those guys. They're in the studio? Oh, that's unbelievable. Can anybody find those guys, bring them in here? Well, Big Sandy?
Yeah.
Oh, man, alive. You know, we just, that's a funny thing that you must have been traveling by here in your car TV and saw yourself on the old kinescope we had back from the Clippy Stone Barn Dance, but you guys have been playing for 40 years now?
41 years old.
41 years? That's wild. That's really terrific, and I'm glad you're still together. I mean, after, you know, all these years, all you guys...
Just like the Four Tops.
Yeah, that's pretty nice. Well, I've just kind of lost track of you ever since, like, the late 50s. Where are you playing now?
Well, we've been playing down at Del Monte Legion Stadium.
That's a little private joke for that back in Scotland. That's been torn down since the 50s. But I actually have heard wind of the fact that you're playing out at Toe's Tavern out in Pasadena.
Yeah, we got a regular Thursday night deal there.
Yeah.
Just featured on Fox News last week. So.
What did they feature? I mean, what was the news? The news was the Big Sandy's playing there? Or that they were showing the tavern? Or what was it?
Well, that there's still some rockabilly and stuff like that going on in town that didn't all die out.
Man, I'm surprised at Fox News.
You know how we all got into it. It asked about the clothes and cars and all that.
Huh. Uh-oh. That wasn't a good one. I think Mr. Todd, Uncle Todd, could you come here and take care of Jesse? She just fell in here and knows. We're going to have... get on the camera. Say hello to the folks at home, Todd. I got to get a babysitter. I just got to get a babysitter.
Hey, hire me, man. How much do you charge?
You guys know bottle to the baby?
So as long as you're all here, I noticed y'all brought your instruments. Would it be possible to rustle up another song for us?
Well, sure. What do you say, boys? You know, fun.
Oh, well, I take your honky-tonkin' and I dress you like a queen. But when I need some loving, you start acting awful mean. Oh, well, I wanna hold you tightly and pitch a little wound. But the same thing happens nightly, you're just too tired to You're no fun.
You're no fun.
I said you're no fun.
No fun.
Well, but that's okay. You're not my only one. But you never want to go. And you'd rather sit and watch TV than to go to the picture show. Well, do you got another man who satisfies your time? 'Cause if you do, I'm telling you, there's something on my mind. You're no fun.
You're no fun.
Oh, baby, you're no fun. Okay, you're not my only one. Yeah, not my only one. Brother Lee Jeffries. Smeared like candy, and there's wrinkles on your dress. Oh, well, I can't be sure you're cheating, but I kind of think it's true. 'Cause you're too tired to walk with me on down the avenue. You're no fun.
You're no fun.
Ah, baby, you're no fun.
No fun.
Well, but that's okay. You're not my only one.
Yeah.
I said you're no fun.
You're no fun.
Oh, baby, you're no fun.
Yeah.
Well, but that's okay. You're not my only one. Oh, well, I take your honky-tonkin' and I dress you like a queen.
Hold that camera on the band. I want to talk to them some more. Tim, maybe you can move over a little that way to get in the picture more. Actually, I've done the interviews with the band members on the first records and stuff, all except for the new guy on steel. That's Lee.
Ooh-wee.
So we don't have a mic on him. Maybe you can lean yours over to him.
Yeah.
And I got to ask Lee. Welcome to the band. Welcome to the Big Sandy and the Fly Ride Boys. We got to ask you what the first record you bought was. More embarrassing, the better.
Let me check with him. I think it was Prince Buster.
Prince Buster.
Yeah.
Oh, you're English.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's not even nobody in America knows. Nobody in America knows what that record is. What? Ten Commandments of Love.
Big Five.
Uh huh. And the first rock and roll show you saw.
I think it was. Man, I can't even remember.
Okay, Tommy Steele. All right, so...
remember, we've been around for 41 years.
41 years. Listen, I was going to talk and then go out on music, but I've heard the talk, and I've heard the music, and the music's better. So why don't we run another song by you guys, and this time put their name all over it. Maybe it ran last time, but I didn't see it much. So on the lower thirds, I like to see the Big Sandy name billboarded as much as possible. So we're going to add another song. You get the same pay. Okay.
All right.
All right. Take it away,
Should
fellas.
We swing it down?
Yeah.
Six, six. Oh, wait. What say we hit it with that jumper from 6 to 6, boys?
One, two, three, four.
Well, my baby went out. She stayed out all night long. Well, my mama went out. She stayed out all night long. Well, she told me to lie. Couldn't find a way back home. She was jumping from 6 to 6. Jumping from 6 to 6. Well, a jumper from 6 to 6. Oh, well, a jumper from looking for fix. She called me up about 25 to beat me up, and daddy don't want to drive. 10 minutes later, her boyfriend called, said, come on, baby, let's have a ball. Jumping from 6 to 6. 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 Well, she got herself in a heck of a fix. Jumping from 6 to 6. Yeah, she got herself in a heck of a fix. Mr. TK. She got herself in a heck of a fix. Come shutting in the door by 12:45. Asked me, Sandy, did I do wrong? I stepped aside and I threw her back. I slapped her right to dead in the eye. Cause she was jumping from 6 to 6. 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 Well, she got herself in a heck of a fix.
Let's keep it on that band. Let's talk to Paul for just a second. All I wanted to say was this must be a very nostalgic night for you. It doesn't take you back to 1952 but it takes you back to 1992, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Because
I saw...
Well, you were in Paris.
I saw them.
Who did you see in Gay Paris?
Dave Alvin and the Paladins.
Yeah.
And Big Sandy at the Slow Club.
In Paris.
In Paris.
That's what they call it.
And both shows were great.
What's the French word for busman? Because you were taking a busman's holiday, you know?
Oh, I don't know what the French word for busman is.
You know busman's holiday? You know that one? No. I mean,
where
the bus, the bus driver's day off, he rides the bus. I mean, he goes to Paris and sees American bands from L.A.
Hey, it was happening, man. I mean, homeboys, but what can I say?
You shouldn't say much of anything, but we got the great Big Sandy and the Fly Right Boys. They sure did billboard them a lot on that time. There was nothing but, so let's, we don't need them anymore because we're going out. The end credits. One more song from Big Sandy. What's the name of some clubs I might look for you at with no dates?
Well, we play at the King King.
Yeah.
Fairly frequently.
Yeah.
Let's see, what else do we do, boys? The Palomino. Yeah. Every once in a while, they'll put together a show.
Where does Spade Cooley used to play? On that ballroom?
Riverside Rancho.
Yeah, Riverside.
Down in Orange County, there's a place that we just played at. We'll hopefully be coming back there soon because it's really good. Yeah. Newport Roadhouse.
Okay.
Had a really good show down there. Bogart's.
All right. Okay.
Others.
All right. So let's go out on the song and thank you guys very much for coming and thanks, Big Sandy.
All right. Thank you. All right. What's some of the hot belly music, boy?
Well, let's take people by the belly beats called hot belly music in the shower is new. Well, that's high belly music. It's a real gone country boogie with the beat. Well, it's a real long gone baby, just the way I like it. Well, it's the only sound that rocks me off my feet. Oh, yeah, baby, I dig that sound. Well, it's go, and round. It's the best kind of music that I've ever found. Well, it's a high, belly music. Oh, rave on, boy. Thank you. don't dig hop-billy music. Other than let me tell you, cats, you're just so square. Cause it's a high-billy music. It's the sound that's sweeping around most everywhere. Well, baby, I dig that sound. Well, it's go, going round. It's the best kind of music that I've ever found around. It's a high-billy music. It's a high-billy music. It's a real gone country boogie with a beat. Well, it's a real long gone, baby, just the way I like it. Well, it's the only sound that rocks me off my feet. Oh, well, baby, I dig that sound. Well, it's a go-go going round. It's the best kind of music that I've ever found. Well, it's a high-billy music. Well, it's a high-billy music. Well, it's a high-billy music. You know, high-billy music is the only sound for me. High-billy music. Hey!
Yeah.